guys, it's Harsh Different Merchants. Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be doing another book review. In today's video, I'm gonna be reviewing the book Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince by J.K. Rowling from the Harry Potter series. Well, this Harry Potter series has been going on for a very long time on this channel right now. This is the sixth book in this series. Each book of the Harry Potter series gives you some life lesson, some skill you have to know, and every book has some value, some life value, which will help you someday. Well, this book does not focus on something like that. This book mainly focuses to enthrall the reader. Yes, you should try this book. Yeah, try the whole Harry Potter series. You'll definitely learn something from that. This book, like I said, it's going to enthrall you. You cannot anticipate what's going to happen next in the next page or even the next line, because you'll be gripped to the book. It's really interesting. So let's get right into the book. Before we see Harry or some other character, we're gonna look at some characters which have not been shown as major characters in this book. That is aurors. So let me explain what aurors are. Aurors are like people who work for the Ministry of Magic, who Harry and his friends encountered last year. That was in the Order of the Phoenix. They had a minister whose name was Cornelius Fudge. Cornelius Fudge comes with an aura to the Muggle Prime Minister. Muggle is basically the term used by wizarding folk for humans. We have prime ministers, and the same way they also have ministers. So they both have, Muggle Prime Minister actually knows that magic exists, but he doesn't want the Muggle people to know. Well, in this book they also say that many Muggle stuff are derived from something that was used from by the wizarding folk. Like, they have broomstick, they have in this book they say that, Muggle people say, in their stories they say that wizards have magic broomsticks, but do you know where that was derived from? Well, some Muggles in the primordial age, they saw that we had broomsticks. Okay, that's the side. Cornelius Fudge is sacked. Yes, he is no longer the Minister of Magic. And they just give us a small flashback, which is like Harry's dream. And in the second chapter, we look at Harry. Harry gets a letter from Albus Dumbledore saying that this year, Albus Dumbledore is gonna pick him up from number 4 Privet Drive, that is the Dursley's house. Harry doesn't know whether Dumbledore is gonna come or not. He's not packed anything, but Dumbledore is gonna come today. He's waiting for Dumbledore to come, and suddenly he sees Dumbledore while he's sitting at his window reading the Daily Prophet. The Daily Prophet is the wizard's newspaper. The pictures in that newspaper actually move, not like how we stand still. It moves. That's really different. Well, Harry's getting used to everything wizardly now, because now he's a great wizard. Well, Albus Dumbledore comes, and Harry still doesn't pack anything. Harry wants to meet Dumbledore as soon as he can. And while Harry is going downstairs, he hears a doorbell, and that is none other than Professor Albus Dumbledore. Dumbledore has actually come to pick him up. Dumbledore tries as much to be normal with the Muggles, that is Mr. Dursley and Mrs. Dursley and Dudley. They're really scared, how they didn't want to reveal to Harry that he was a wizard. They're really scared that Albus Dumbledore himself has come to their house. Albus Dumbledore does some magic and everybody's scared. The second chapter is really funny. And after that, before they go to Hogwarts or any other place, Albus Dumbledore has to reveal something to Harry. In the last book, Harry's godfather, Sirius Black, died. And Sirius had a house called Number 12, Grimmauld Place, and a house elf called Creature. Now, as per Sirius Black's will, everything passes back into Harry Potter. So Harry is the owner of everything Sirius owned in the past. After that, Dumbledore says that, Harry, we have a small work to do before we go. And that was to... Dumbledore wants to recruit a potions teacher. Well, you might be thinking, we had already a potions teacher in the last few books. that was Severus Snape. Yes, that was Severus Snape. But this teacher is Horace Slughorn. Horace Slughorn has been turning down a lot of opportunities to come there. And eventually they recruit him and they go back to the burrow. And there, after that, Dumbledore says that, Harry, I'm going to be taking some private lessons for you. And Harry is really thrilled to get those private lessons. Soon they go to Hogwarts and the private lessons start. So let me just tell you what the private lessons are. 2 books ago, Lord Voldemort arised again from the dead. Well, after that, the battles has been going on for a very long time. And Dumbledore wants to train Harry to fight Lord Voldemort. He uses an instrument called the Pensieve. And eventually, the thing is, Albus Dumbledore dies. Yeah, Albus Dumbledore dies by the hands of Severus Snape. Yeah, it's a conspiracy. Nobody knows why Severus Snape killed Albus Dumbledore. Finally, they build a white tomb for Albus Dumbledore. Well, all the time, yeah, there was Albus Dumbledore was already dying. How was he already dying? He went on some adventures with Harry Potter to find out missing Horcruxes. Let me tell you what Horcruxes are. Horcruxes are pieces, some objects that hold part of your soul. Voldemort had 7 Horcruxes and they collected 3 Horcruxes. And at that time, Albus Dumbledore drank some poison and he was already dying. By the time Severus Snape killed him, he was totally dead. So that's the end of the book, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, leave a like on this video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. If you want any other series or have any questions, you can just leave a comment in the comment section below and I'll be definitely replying to you. So bye then. Guys, wait. The book review is not over yet. I have to reveal something. If you don't want any spoilers to this book or the movie you're gonna watch for The Half-Blood Prince, do not watch this clip. I repeat, do not watch this. But if you have already seen the movie, you can watch this. And if you really want the spoiler, you can definitely watch this clip. Okay, I have to tell you a main thing. Do you know why this book is called Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince? Let me tell you. I told you, right? There was a potions master called Horace Slughorn. Well, he's taking potions now and Harry's favorite subject is potions. He doesn't like potions so far. Well, why is it his favorite subject is potions now? It's because a person called the Half-Blood Prince. Yeah, the Half-Blood Prince has a potions book, his chapter, where he invents spells and gives you shortcuts for all these spells and potions. Well, this is the surprise. The Half-Blood Prince is none other than Severus Snape. Why is he the Half-Blood Prince? He is the Half-Blood Prince because his father was a wizard and his mother was a muggle. So half-blood, and he considers himself a prince. Thank you guys. Bye.